You're about to hear the only advertising program on BBC. It's topical, it's non-political, it's the first radio program without a blue streak.
It's something to shout about, it's something to shout about, it's something to shout about and cry out loud.
It's new, it's heartwarming,
it's non-habit forming.
We can really guarantee it's something, something to shout about.
It's the most sensational thing since Lady Chatterley took up gardening. It's... it's new, it's different, but it's no better.
It's something to shout about,
not
it's something
again.
To shout about.
Please!
It's
so inartistic. Where was I? It's the new non-habit-forming show with a miracle mystery ingredient, people. Michael Medwin with Eleanor Summerfield, Fenella Fielding and Joan Sims, and a cast of several, bring you a light-hearted expose of the advertising world.
Michael, darling, are you ready to sign these letters?
Certainly, darling. I mean, Janet. Now, what did I do with my pen?
I'll bring them over.
I know I had it earlier because I did the crossword puzzle. Now, where on earth is it?
Mr. Lightfoot's office. Just a moment.
Oh, I don't know where it is.
Well, I'll look for it. There's a call for you. Perhaps in your inside pocket. Let me see if I can find it.
Hello? Oh, good morning, J.S. Janet, what are you doing? Oh, sorry, J.S. yes, sir, I'm listening. Oh, dear. Oh, yes, that is bad. Oh, I'm awfully sorry. Oh, for heaven's sake, go away. No, no, not you, sir. No, I was talking to my secretary. She's tidying my in tray. Oh, have they really? Oh, well, I see that doesn't happen again, J.S. Oh, I am sorry, sir. Yes, well, I'll have to try and get some new clients somehow. Okay, J.S., goodbye. Thanks for the massage, Janet.
I enjoyed it.
Well, J.S. didn't. He's in a flaming temper this morning.
Well, he always is.
Yeah, I know, but he doesn't always open the conversation by calling me a pea-brained, useless streak of nothing. He usually waits till the end.
Has my darling been a naughty boy?
Often, but this time during working hours. I've lost a client.
How careless.
If I don't get some new clients, I'm going to get the push.
Oh,
J.S.
darling, I can't bear to see you looking so worried.
Well, I am worried. I've got my old age to think about.
Oh, let's make the most of my fleeting youth. Let's live. Let me look for your pen again.
Now, Janet, Janet! Janet! Janet, stop it!
Hello, young lover.
Hello, Maggie. We were just looking for something.
You'll be looking for another secretary if you're not careful.
No, not at all. I find Janet ample.
I see what you mean.
You're very full of sweetness and light this morning.
Oh, well, I want to borrow a tin opener.
Tin opener?
Yes, a client has sent me a new sort of cat food called moggy meat.
So naturally you want to try it.
Yes. I'm auditioning cats this morning for the TV commercials. No good picking a photogenic Persian, only to discover at the studio that it's a vegetarian.
Well, I may have one in my bottom drawer.
A vegetarian?
I shouldn't be at all surprised. Cats too, probably. There are things in Janet's bottom drawer that even Sir Mortimer Wheeler couldn't identify.
I make it a golden rule never to throw anything away.
Honestly, Maggie, it's like working with a jackdaw who can type.
I say, Michael. Are you looking for a new client?
Desperately.
Well, old chap, you know that big American firm, Dainty Suds Soap Manufacturing Company, the one that does me lady soap?
Oh, of course I do. And what a soap. And what a slogan. You start the day right if you take a bath with me lady. Oh.
Well, they're bringing out a new product. Have you got the advertising world?
It's usually lying about.
I know, but what's it lying about this week?
Here it is.
Well, take a look at the middle page.
Madison Avenue is bristling with rumors about Dainty Suds' new product, which is still top, top secret. Vice President Hartley B. Pimslow II, when asked to comment on this, replied, "I'm not going to confirm that we have a new product, and I am not going to deny it. But if Dainty Suds Inc. does have something up its sleeve, believe me, it won't be a red herring."
It doesn't say much, but it could mean a lot.
It's like saying we're just good friends.
If only you could get the advertising account for this new product.
Yeah, old J.S. would love me again.
I wonder if I could fly to New York on the petty cash. Janet, ring up BOAC and ask them if they take luncheon vouchers.
Oh, you don't have to bother. Look what it says at the bottom of the page. Mr. Hartley B. Pimslow II is arriving in London tonight.
Yeah, let's see. Hartley B. is flying to Europe on the 18th. Yes, that's the day. His first scheduled stop will be London, England. I'll find out what time his plane arrives, then I'm going to meet him and give him the big Oklahoma hello.
Is that anything like the long Susie Wong goodbye?
No, Madam Butterfly, it isn't. Now, you leave Mr. Hartley B. to me. I shall meet him at the airport, and with my irresistible charm, I shall lure the account out of him. Now, what is it that Americans like? What is it that Americans go for?
Morning, no.
Well, there's one answer.
Mavis, you're supposed to be in the typing pool.
I know, but I escaped.
Look, what have you done today?
My hair, my nails, and sixpence on the big race. Honestly, there's no work down there. It's dreary.
We'll soon be bashing the keyboard again. Mr. Lightfoot's hoping to get a big new account.
Now, where were we? Oh, yes. How can we impress this American?
Did you say American?
Yes.
Well, gorgeous. I'm an expert on them.
You know, I thought you might be.
If I remember rightly, old girl, there used to be a GI who came in to pick you up at the office.
Oh, that's right. Hank, his name was. Didn't half speak funny. Used to say tomatoes instead of martyrs. We was going steady. I saw him three nights running.
Yeah, then you slowed down and let him catch you. Now, Mavis, if you're an expert, have you got any ideas how to impress our American client?
Well, they do like their own food. One night, Hank took me to a cafe, and you know what he ordered? Chicken and pineapple. Chicken and pineapple? I ask you, it put me right off my kippers and jam.
All right, we'll be careful about his food. But what else can we do to create a big impression when we meet him?
Well, Americans like blondes.
Then take Mavis.
And they're crazy about history. They like ruins.
Then take Maggie.
Nah, just...
No. Girls, will you stop it, please? We'll take Mavis. Adrian, there ought to be something else, something to make him feel important when he arrives.
Perhaps you could get London Airport to give him some preferential treatment.
Now, my mum had that for her fallen arches. They put your feet in a bowl of water.
All right. All right, Mavis, that'll do. Now, Maggie, that's a very good idea. We'll give him the full VIP treatment.
Oh, they'll never do that, Elmer.
Oh, nonsense. I'll fix it.
Wish to announce the departure of flight 762 for Rome, Athens, and Beirut.
But it's absolutely essential that Mr. Pimslow gets VIP treatment. I mean, you can't subject an eminent American to the customs, being weighed and given blood tests and so forth.
I'm sorry, sir, but Mr. Pimslow is not on our VIP list.
Only really important people qualify for VIP treatment.
Well, American crooners get it when they arrive.
Yeah, but hardly ever when they leave.
And British rock and roll singers who've made one record, they get it if they leave the country.
I should think most of them have to.
What about Barbara Moore?
Oh, she always travels on foot.
Now, if you'll excuse me, sir.
Any joy, Michael?
I say, Adrian, oh boy. Adrian Beale's delighted to see you.
Fruity! What a surprise! Well,
must be at least 5 years.
That's right, B Squadron. Happy days.
Dirty nights. Here.
I say, Fruity, old chap, can you help me?
Always did.
Well, I'm in a spot of bother.
What's her name?
No, you see, Michael, this gentleman and I are in advertising.
Oh, the frothy coffee boys.
Yes. We've got a prospective client coming in on the jet clipper. We must impress him. Can you lay on...
Oh, no, sorry, just been going into that. No can do. Tell you what, though, I'll give you a pass and you can take your car out and meet him off the plane, and then he'll be first through the customs and all that malarkey.
Oh, thanks, Fruity. You are a sport. Well, where is he?
I can't see anyone who looks like that photograph.
What about that chap over there?
Which chap?
The one with a pale green face, shaky hands, and a nervous twitch.
That's the pilot. Oh, I say, that's him. Look, coming down the gangplank. Oh, good evening, sir. Mr. Pimslow?
That's correct. I'm Hartley B. Pimslow II. Have a tranquilizer.
No, thank you, sir. I'm driving. Now, I'm from...
Yes, I know. That advertising firm who cabled me.
Oh, that's it, sir. Apsley, Addis, Cohen, Barbican, Blythe and Giddy Partners. I'm Michael Lightfoot, account executive. And this is Adrian Beals, one of Britain's foremost copywriters.
How do you do, sir?
Howdy.
And this is Mavis Willis, one of Britain's foremost typists.
It's charmed to meet you.
Well, any friend of yours is a friend of mine.
How are you, Mr. Pimsleur?
I'm a sick man. My stomach's been making acid right away across the Atlantic. I doubt if I'll make the customs check.
Oh, don't you worry, sir. Our car's right here. Step in, will you?
We'll whip you through in a couple of seconds. VIP treatment, eh?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.